guys, it's Teresa here of Larkin Design, and so welcome to my series. I think that what I'm going to call this series is Things I Need to Hear, and so it's sort of a developing thing that I've been working on some traditional layouts, some 12 by 12 layouts, about things that I need to hear in my life right now, and probably things that you need to hear as well. Hopefully you'll hear some affirming messages through this series, and also, of course, find some inspiring layouts that will help you create some meaningful layouts for yourself. And so today I'm working on a layout called Take Time to Recharge, and I'm starting with this patterned paper from Pinkfresh Studio from the Indigo Hills collection, and I have a photo. The photo credit goes to my husband, Alan. He took this. I've rediscovered vanilla tea. And so a fond part of my childhood is when we were living in Germany, and this was in the early to mid 80s. And it was popular then, and probably still is, to have a traditional tea time. And one of my favorite things while we were there was to have vanilla tea. And what they would do, since I was like 8 years old, they would put a little touch of milk in it for me and some sugar cubes. And so I have really fond memories of having vanilla tea. And for a long, long time in the U.S., you couldn't find it. And I've sort of looked off and on, and just for many years just didn't really pay attention. I don't drink a lot of hot drinks. I don't drink coffee at all. But recently we were just at the grocery store, and I found a tin of vanilla tea, and so I thought I would get it. And I've been enjoying having just a little cup of tea just to sit down and relax for a few minutes and put everything out of my mind and just enjoy what I'm holding in my hand. And so this was the essence of what I wanted to carry into this layout, was just a reminder to myself, because what has happened is that in my process of making the tea and sitting down to drink it has reminded me of how important it is just to sit down for 5 minutes. I tend to be go, 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 and then crash and burn. And so I'm relearning how to just sit for 5 minutes, put everything out of my mind, and just relax for a minute and focus on what's in my hands, this warm cup that smells divine. Vanilla tea smells so good. And so I'm just holding it in my hand. And so that's my reminder to you this week, to just sit for 5 minutes here and there. I think we all tend to be go, go, go people. And sometimes we do need to just sit down for a minute. Just bring some of that calm to where you are right now. So what I've done so far is I've stamped my title. I've done a combination of stamping my title and planned out where my photo is going, and then I also used some simple stories alphabets to create the word recharge. After that, I went to the cut shop at Etsy.com, and the cut shop is owned by Ashley Horton, very, very talented, amazing designer, and her shop is filled with incredible cut files that you can use on your Silhouette or on your Cricut. And so I went and grabbed this one. I just forgot what it's called, so I'll have to add it to the screen, and I'll add a link below where you can get this one as well. And it's a floral that's sort of just freehand drawn. And so my plan here's my plan for this cut file. I'm not going to put the cut file itself on the layout. What I'm wanting to do is, and you'll see what it looks like here. I'm just getting ready to lift it up cautiously. For some reason, my cutting mat is really sticky this time, and I've taken fabric and sort of tried to lift some of that adhesive off, but it's still kind of sticky. So I'm just trying to be really careful here, lifting it up. But what my plan is, I actually want to spray around this cut file, and then I want to sew these squiggly circles. You can see that the flowers on this cut file are sort of just freehand circles, and what I'm wanting is those freehand circles stitched using my sewing machine. So right now I'm just carefully lifting this up and trying to get it off the cutting mat. And I've just cut this on thinner white cardstock. I'm not actually going to keep this one because it's going to get sprayed, and that's fine. Just use your cheapy cardstock for these. Now, I could totally have laid this on the layout and kept the original cut file. That totally would have been beautiful to do. You'll also notice I copied this cut file. When you purchase it, it's only half of that, and I copied it in the Silhouette software and then welded them together so that it would be a little bit bigger and scatter across the layout. And so what I'm going to do here, I had a little piece that didn't quite cut a little bit. But what I'm going to do here is establish a diagonal line from the lower left-hand corner to the upper right-hand corner. And my floral pattern is going to follow that, and then my embellishments are going to follow that line as well. So this is the direction that your eye is going to take, in theory. This is the direction your eye is going to take across the page, from lower left hand to upper right hand. There. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to tape off mask off the title here. I don't want to lose that. And I'm also going to put the outer frame back around the cut file as well, so that I don't spray beyond the flowers themselves. I'm trying to contain how much I'm spraying on the layout. The spraying is not going to be, it's not intended to be like this major noticeable thing. There's already a lot going on this pattern paper. I chose it for the splashes of color. Absolutely love these colors, and love that they already have a hand-painted feel to them. What I'm doing here is layering another color to the three that are on the pattern paper. There's mint, there's a mustard yellow color, and a pink. And then I'm going to spray this with my Heidi Swap Coral, just to add one more layer of color, and again to give me the circle patterns for the sewing. So I've just grabbed a little 3x4 thin piece of cardstock to tape over my title here so that it doesn't get sprayed. And I'm just going to tape that off. I'm just using some simple washi tape. And then I just need to mask off the corners of the layout as well. and then this will be ready to spray. Now I have some of my ephemera that I've laid out. I've kind of already planned a little bit in my head what I want to do with the embellishments on this layout. So that's why they're still, you know, sort of around the layout and stuff. Now I grabbed an older white foam board to put down so that I could just spray this real quick where it is on my desk. And that's simply all I did. Very quick, not very heavy on color, and there you can see how that sort of turned out. And again, this isn't supposed to be a major focal point of the layout. It's just something to add those circles as the base for my stitching. I'm gonna just heat set real quick. The Heidi Swap Shine dries pretty quickly already, but I added just a little tiny bit of heat just to make sure before I run it through my sewing machine. So I've grabbed my sewing machine here, and this is somewhat of an experiment because I'm wanting to sew in circles, and that's not always easy to do. And it's not easy to do with a sewing machine. I think that I would love to do some sewing with a quilting machine, with a long arm quilting machine, because then your machine itself wouldn't get in the way of making the patterns that you're wanting, or making the circles that I was wanting. But anyway, I chose this really light mint green, and it really just looks white on the paper once it's sewn down, and that's fine. So I've just threaded my bobbin here, and I'm gonna put that in and then get ready to sew some circles. So this is probably gonna look a little bit crazy from above and in fast forward, and that's okay. And I have to tell you that doing concentric circles like this on the sewing machine kind of requires you to let go of an expected outcome and accept the outcome that is. And again, this is not designed to be the focal point of the layout. It's simply a background. So whether these circles come out perfect or not perfect isn't really the point. The point is just to add a little bit of stitching and to enjoy a little bit of texture underneath the embellishments that I plan to add. So this is just a combination of taking it off the machine and moving it to a different flower and then putting it back and stitching some more circles. Now, I'm going to just tell you that I know there are a lot of really talented scrapbookers out there who do this by hand, and I am in awe of scrapbookers who do hand stitching on their layouts. It's something that I can't physically do. Sewing by hand makes my hands really cramp up, and I don't have any issues or anything. I've always been like that. Writing for long periods of time by hand will make my hand cramp up. So it's not something, hand stitching isn't something that I really enjoy doing, and something that I'm not. It's just not for me. But you can do stitching with the sewing machine, and if you like that look, then you should do it by all means. I can tell you that I probably use my sewing machine more for paper sewing than fabric sewing. I don't do a lot of sewing particularly. I do sew all of our curtains, all the curtains that are in our house, I did. I don't mind doing that, but as far as sewing clothes and stuff like that, no. This is the primary use that my sewing machine gets, and that's okay. So this is kind of funny to watch, isn't it? It just goes around and around in circles. I hate that you can't really see, like, what I'm doing as it goes through the machine. I need a second camera angle. But I am mainly trying to follow that diagonal line with the stitching. So I'm not stitching every single floral element, just a couple along that diagonal line. Totally random, and again, just totally for background effect. And then with that, I'm done. And so now I'm going to trim up all the loose ends. I cut them pretty closely on the top. And then on the back, I just trim them out. And then I'm going to cover all the stitching on the back with washi tape, just to keep it secure on the back. And wide washi tape is a good kind to use here, because then it gives you more coverage. This tape is from, oh boy, it just left my brain. I think it's from the Crepe Paper Oasis collection. And so that's my stitching. Now I'm ready to layer my ephemera and my photo onto the layout itself. I'm going to use a little of this vellum. This is also part of the Indigo Hills collection, and it's a beautiful foiled vellum. And so I've just cut a little bit around my photo. My photo is about 4 by 4 1/4, 4 1/2 or something. I don't know. And then I'm just going to back it with this little, with the little vellum. And adhere it down, and then this will become a foundation for some of the ephemera that I'm going to add as well. I'll add a cluster at the bottom here. So this is a little tab, I guess, from Indigo Hills. And so I have sort of conceptualized what I want to do with the ephemera on this page. There were a lot of circle elements included in the Indigo Hills collection, and I also had these circle chipboard embellishments from my Allie Edwards story kits. There were a couple of things that I went through and pulled from my story kits, this stamp set and some of the ephemera that were, and some of the chipboard pieces, and so I wanted to use those. This is the Tough stamp set, and there were just some expressions there that were a part of that stamp set that fit this layout and fit the feel of what I was wanting to say in this layout. So for the embellishment cluster at the top of the photo, it's going to include a cloud paperclip. It's from Freckled Fawn, and a stamped sentiment. And I'll probably go back later and add something else to the top of the photo. And then at the bottom, there's a little wood veneer cup and a chipboard sentiment. The wood veneer cup, I think, is from Gossamer Blue. And the chipboard phrase is from Allie Edwards. And so here's where the circles come in at. I wanted to create embellishment clusters following this diagonal line. And so I wanted each embellishment cluster to have a circle plus a phrase, whether it was a chipboard phrase or a stamp sentiment or a piece of cardstock ephemera, and then possibly a shaped paper clip or a wood veneer piece of ephemera. And so each cluster has a little grouping, and I pulled a couple of little wood ephemera, like the word real that's at the top, that's from Allie Edwards. Some wooden hearts, those are from Maggie Holmes. I think they're from the confetti, that really expensive jar that had ephemera in it. And the shaped, I pulled a couple of shaped paper clips, just some random things that actually pull together to make each little cluster. So it ends up that there's a lot to see on this layout, and a lot of fun little pieces, little bits and pieces. This is a great way to use up some of your miscellaneous things, but there's also a method to it, right? Because each cluster has a circle and a cardstock or chipboard ephemera. There's also, I'm using a couple of these epoxy flowers. This cream one right here is from Tim Holtz. And then there's a pink one up above. And I think that pink one is from the jewelry section in Michaels or something. I don't really have a source for that. It's something that I just took apart from like a beading package or something like that. I still like to collect those little epoxy flowers. I don't use them a lot because they're bulky, but they do add a little tiny touches here to these clusters. And so basically, I'm just going around the page and filling out each cluster. They are all somehow connected, and I think that the stitching and the sprayed cut file help to connect all of these pieces. And again, they help lead your eye diagonally across this layout. And they just provide a great visual interest. There's a lot to see on this layout. But they all have something to say. And so let me read to you what some of these things say here that I've included on the layout. Let's see. At the top of the page, there's an orange. It looks like an orange speech bubble. It's from Allie Edwards. It says, "It doesn't get easier, you just get better." And then the wood word that says real. Right? Both reminders that I'm needing. And then right next to it, it says happy. And the little chipboard ephemera says, keep the faith. And then underneath that is moments captured with heart or captured with love. And notice how I repeated the heart that's on the circle with the little camera clip that has a heart inside it. That's from the Hazelwood collection, that little shaped clip that was just released at, or just came out in December or January. There's also circles that say, this matters, and pieces of my life, and another chipboard piece that says, one that says, the best is yet to come, and another one that says, take heart. And also across the bottom, It says, you are capable of amazing things, and of course, enjoy. The chipboard piece on the photo itself, the yellow one, it says, here's to you. And then the stamp sentiment at the top of the photo says, life in progress. That's from the Allie Edwards Tough stamp set. Let's see, I'm going to do a little, a little tab, the date stamp, and that's going to go at the top of the layout, and that is also stamped to say, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. And then there's a pink heart clip that you can see right there. It's on the happy circle. That heart clip will get added to this cluster at the very top right here. That heart is from Michael's. I think it was just in one of their bins, maybe last year at Valentine's Day or something. I don't know. The shaped paper clips that I have, I just collect them, and some of them I've had for years and years. So that's definitely one of them. The cloud shaped clip is from, I think it's from Freckled Fawn. Yeah. And then I'm adding another wood heart at the top as well. Finishing up that enjoy circle. My plan is that it will go off the page, so when I go back and trim that bottom marketing strip off, I will trim that enjoy circle off as well. And then I'm ready to write my journaling. So I'm going to make some lines here. I'm going to use the Becky Higgins roller stamp. That's part of the Project Life collection. And I'm going to use the dotted lines. And the dotted lines, they aren't quite wide enough for what I'm wanting to do. But I'm just going to double up each line and stamp each line twice. And so I already know in my mind that the lines are going to be irregular. They're going to be, it's hard to match them up if you're stamping one line twice like that. It's going to be hard to match them up. I am sort of using this ruler as a guideline. This is about the only time that you will ever see me use a ruler. And it's not because I'm looking for perfect lines and know they're not going to be perfect. But it is sort of a guideline so I can keep track for myself of where I'm stamping. So my lines are set and ready to go, and then I'm just going to jot down my thoughts. And so let me read you my thoughts. I wrote, yep, every day is hard. Lots of work, lots of emotions, lots of hard stuff. But you're doing it day by day. Just remember, lovely one, to take the time to rest. Even if it's just to enjoy a cup of hot vanilla tea, enjoy the simple things. That will pretty much wrap up this layout. I think I'm going to add just one more wood piece right here. And so let me go ahead and wrap up. Thanks so much for watching. I do hope that you will like, comment, and subscribe. And also feel free to share this video. If you know of someone, or you need these messages yourself, or you know of someone who needs these messages, please share these videos. Let other people know that I'm doing this series. For now, the plan is every Friday I'm creating and sharing with you a Things I Need to Hear layout. So thanks again for watching, and I'll see you back here again soon. Bye-bye, you guys.